And we get a Visage.
Yeah, should have seen it coming. This is one of the Wii specials. His Windranger, his Visage, his Pugna. Those were heroes he was spamming for quite some time. Mm-hmm. And, you know, to quote, you know, God's, he said it's a terrible hero. I'm not going to say it's
hey, you're not gonna say
ideal,
it's a good hero.
But I love the combination with the Liquid lineup. This is something that Wings used to do, something that CDEC used to do. You've got the Visage Ember combination. It's that concept that Liquid used in the previous game as well. Very short cooldown stuns, constant spam slows. You'll have bird damage coming in, the Fatal Bond spread. Mm-hmm. You've got tons of vision as well. So theoretically, you can outplay Vici around the map, who are completely reliant right now on a sick game from DY to find kills.
Yeah, because they got to go with momentum, right? Like, this is a VG lineup which has homing missile and Glimpse as the only, I'm going to use quote stuns, like, because Glimpse is like, it'll cancel, but that's it. It takes time before it happens.
And what's Disruptor weak against? Heroes running at him. And that's what Visage, Ember, and Beastmaster are all going to look to do here. I love the combination as well, just the Beastmaster with the Grimstroke roar into Inkswell follow-up with ease. Mm-hmm. They obviously put that on Miracle as well.
Yep.
They do a good job of trying to activate his hero at all times.
Just simple combination, simple to execute. Wow, this sounds very, very similar to what we were saying actually about VG's draft in Game 1 of this series.
They're using ideas that we've seen in the past as well, going back to the DAC, first LAN I ever casted, Mineski.
Wow, who would
on
ever
the back.
Who would remember that in the quiz?
DP Gyro. Mineski was just first toing. Mm-hmm. And the heroes have changed, the meta's changed, but you know, we get back closer to TI, we see Wiz Gyro again, the DP, the perfect complement. You're at a position where Vici can get tempo, get a kill, and just find themselves in front of Liquid's base. Their team fight's insane. You don't need stuns if you're camped on top of the enemy high ground.
Uh-huh. And I want to keep my eye on mind control as well in the bottom lane. Fade and Paparazzi, this dual lane Paparazzi needs to bring the damage nice and early, bring the rain. The mind control boars help you zone out, so does the warlock, especially when they share this damage. Obviously, it's a fantastic regeneration lane at the same time, but how was mind control going to do? He had a free doom lane previously against the Omni Knight. This game, he feels a little bit like more efficient with the farm he's going to get.
Yeah.
Actually, he'll do something.
it'll be more of a traditional mind control game. I think that the last game we saw was just Vici. You know, they didn't want to make a mistake, sure, but it was Liquid just unable to play their game. And it's mostly because of the Fade Rubick. So it looks like GH and MC had off games, but, you know, any time they misused a spell was going to get swiped. MC this time, more of a standard, like, high-pressure lane shove style. They last band tied, or fifth band tied into the Beastmaster because Darkseer was taken out by Vici in that second phase as well. So you don't really have a hard counter to this Beastmaster, though the Omni Knight Heavenly Grace is excellent at just cleansing that roar immediately, preventing the initiation to follow up from Liquid.
Yeah, only issue is when that happens. Too much initiation. Inkswell, Searing Chains all started off with the Slide of Fist, allowed Miracle to close the distance. And Disruptor is very weak in that part of the lane. He can harass with a Thunderstrike, but he cannot be that initiation saver like the Rubick is, where he can pick up and just throw somebody back.
Yeah. And it's Grimstroke Ember, even in the offlane. This is such a formidable lane composition. You get easy double stuns.
Yeah, you still got a decent amount of farm, though. Like, it's still 6-1 versus the 7-4, 8-4 of the Omni Knight. Mid 11-3 on the Death Prophet against 7-2 Visage. Gyrocopter's gotten, Gyrocopter's getting 9-4 on this bottom lane against Beastmaster 6-4, so all the CS is still looking good for VG early on.
Yeah, and it is a DP favorite matchup, but once you get 6 on Visage, that's where things start to change.
They're skipping again on top lane, really going underneath the tower with a double Inkswell, but remember Miracle, and got a lot of damage from that Thunderstrike. And GH can harass back, but he can't kill back. In fact, okay, DY is going to wall it up. Can Yang move in with a Purify or something like that? Won't happen. GH just walks himself back, TP's himself back to the lane.
It's interesting that he does it then, because you can see the lane is pushing. So you're not really concerned now. Miracle can be left alone. He'll just run away, and GH will bring him items because the wave will push into his tower. Sure, you get a couple creeps denied, but it's all good. You have control.
And they're really trying to beat the crap out of Io on the bottom. Open up that lane. Fate's used all of his extra consumables as well, so he's just down to stick charges. That's all he's got.
Yeah.
So that lane is dry.
All three lanes going in the direction of Vici Gaming at the moment. It's big for them. They can be the aggressors here. Paparazzi gets big. You don't really have many answers to a super fat gyrocopter in this game as Liquid. You can one strong flak, the birds, the boars, the supports in the back line. They have real difficulty staying alive.
Lane's never dry when you've got a courier. Special delivery for Fate. And Even Ember's having a hard time up on top lane. Yep. Just dropping real low, but that's why they're initiating in on over on Yang. Quick slider fist. DY, he's thinking about actually turning around. Miracle's got the creep wave with him, but no stick charge is being popped.
He had the right idea.
Goes down.
He had the right idea. He would have been fine if he heals up, and because DY is turning around to auto attack, he's probably going to be able to get the kill. But you know what he didn't expect was the second point in the disruptor Q. The Thunderstrike damage was enough to kill Miracle. Level one, he would have stayed alive. Just did not expect the damage from DY. And I like that decision because you need that DPS output. Otherwise, this Ember Grimstroke lane is going to be able to play way too aggressive on your Omni Knight.
That makes a lot of sense too, because like, why would you level up Glimpse? Put up in Kinetic Field? All right.
Yeah, but exactly.
It doesn't get you as much.
You're not playing aggressive in that lane.
Yeah. Now your Static Link is out and Paparazzi just wants to keep everybody back.
Look at the denies, that's the thing. VG Gaming right now, the gold, only a slightly, but an experience. They're surely ahead. And they're gonna go Shrine bottom, it appears. Yep, yep. Hit the Bounty Rune, go Shrine, no problem.
Everyone's gonna go 2-2 trade-off, so no contests over this. Yep. Still waiting to feel like Liquid's presence. Like at the moment, VG Gaming, net worth-wise, they're great in every single lane. Like. The Ember Spirit's doing pretty decent up on top lane, but when do we start feeling the presence of Weehai? You fifth pick this hero. It's meant to have a purpose. When is this purpose for this Visage?
It's level 6. It's level 6, Helm of the Dominator. You are pretty worthless until that point, but then you start being able to apply damage to towers. I think a nerf that maybe Liquid aren't prepared for, though, you can no longer dominate those catapults. That was a big part of what made the Visage pushes so threatening, but now it's no longer an option.
Disruptor trying to come and gank before Weehar is able to hit his level 6. And Ahri, he just needs to get closer for a Spirit Siphon. It's actually been really rough for Weehar. He's getting everything denied by Ahri.
Yep.
Range creeps up the hill, no missed chances. It's just been, it's been rough.
It's because, one, he's been forced to buy too many consumables thanks to the harassment of this Ahri Death Prophet. But also, he's rushing the HOD. No real stat items to help him last hit. Ahri, he's going to go for the double null into phase, as most DPs traditionally do. It gives him a significant last hitting advantage and the animation as well. Now that we are 6, though, things change. And he can look to apply way more pressure, especially with the Blightstone and Bassi already acquired.
Yeah, you see, it's like, I gotta take out this catapult first, let me find my farm. Look, DY's trying to deny it. No, not gonna get the right timing on that.
I like this, because the one thing is, if he doesn't get a Q off on the Disruptor, there's no real way you're gonna be able to take him down. And it looks like Ori's gonna go all the way towards bottom.
Yeah, they leave Disruptor in mid instead.
Yeah, well, the thing is, DP can't stay in middle. No one can lane mid against this Death Prophet right now.
It's actually being pushed with Grimstroke as well. They really want to force this lane down.
And Ori, he's wasting a lot of time here.
He's TPing back now mid. They'll have to try and go for the defense. Wall's already up. Weehar already trapped inside of this. The TP out starts to begin. They've got Ninxwall to get the extra stuns. That's a lot of wasted abilities from VG.
Do they get the birds is the question. I think they got at least one.
One's away, two's away. They're both away.
Even with the ultimate, not enough damage. Well played by Wee there. Recognizing the big weakness of VG Gaming. You don't have any stuns.
Someone get that many Yule Scepter. some kind of interrupt for VG. Yeah. Or else it's just going to continuously happen. Like, you know, we always watch the old days, like when there was no stuns and you had like a Weaver in the game. And like, these guys would be like, okay, well, you don't kill him because you can't stun him and he'll always just time-lapse off all the damage. How do you control Miracle going into this later
game? That's the thing. I would traditionally favor Liquid's draft. You know, I'm a big fan of stuns. But the way VG played last game, the way they've won their lanes thus far...
How clean
you know,
it was.
If they can play as clean as they did in the previous game, it'll be near impossible for Liquid to win fights because they need VG to overextend, make a mistake, miss reload, not be prepared with a Grace Cleanse on a Roar. And I just don't know if VG's going to give them those opportunities.
Oh. Again with the Fatal Bonds, but Mind Control doesn't have 6 just yet. So there's no real opportunity to go into Fade, and even if they did, you'd need a heavier rotation than what they've currently got. You'd either need Rock, or you would need Weehar's Birds.
Yep.
Even if Weehar doesn't go himself, his Birds can still do the split push.
But that's not a thing, Tobes. He's going to have to get the HOD, then he'll look to start moving, and you need that creep before you can get out of here.
Something to actually tank and move in the lane for you, sure. He's getting closer. And the gap is starting to close on the net worth. The supports for VG Gaming are not having the greatest game.
But they don't need their supports.
Well, they need the IO to be the healing bomb. Like, that's one thing. But yeah, I suppose as long as he can control Bounty Runes, that bottle is going to give all the heal it needs to go to Paparazzi. Yeah.
The thing is that Vici's mid game is just absolutely insane. They have so much Rust spell damage if the DP and gyro ults go off. It's part of the reason, you know, back in the day, Mineski was willing to first two those heroes in conjunction because you simply cannot fight them mid game. Drums BKB on the gyro, Yul's on the DP. Trying to burst somebody with Yang nearby, it's not going to be possible. And fighting into Vici removes the weakness of the draft, the lack of stuns and disable.
And why does it feel like DY just gets the rejection lanes of Vici? No. Hey, sit in the trees, you're level four. Just soak up some experience, let Miracle have a free lane now.
Yeah, he's just trying to get his XP up. Tome will be out in 30 seconds. Then he wants to be able to just grab six, and then he can start playing more aggressive around the map. DY is the playmaker for his team. That's why his XP is being prioritized. They need that max level glimpse ASAP.
And they really want to fight on bottom lane. Soulbind, but you need Mind Control to have six. You need the double roar to make this lane work, and Mind Control's coming way too much damage. They'll give him some heal back. Thanks to the Shadow Word of Kura, but he's low on mana, low on life. And Ori's rotation that will allow them to control the 10-minute bounty runes, but they don't get top. Ember owns that. And Miracle even comes with a wave. He may actually lose the other rune because of that. Yang is moving off the mid lane. So yeah, they're actually going to get a 3-for-1 trade-off, but it's a 10-minute bounty rune. We'll start to care a lot more as the game goes later.
And look at that. Immediately, 10 minutes hits. Tome, smoke purchased, DY ready to rock and roll. Even though he's close to 6, he does not care. It's all about more points in the glimpse.
Miracle is totally thinking about committing, and DY is trying to make him feel like he should.
Yeah, because the Tome's coming. He'll be level 6 in a moment.
Yep.
There's the Ursa creep. This is so much attack speed on these birds. They already have a very low BAT, so they can start shredding through
Miracle's
structures.
Going for it. I think he got the side of his Syrian chains off on Disruptor. Yep, he'll get the kill. Even with level 6, he didn't commit anything. Miracle burns his last bit of mana to get that. Just keeping the pressure on. And Miracle is getting very close to number one net worth. Probably the reason why Paparazzi had to come back to this lane. Yang, we have birds, move forward. Looking for the chain stuns out just to keep that control going. With the Tomato on the front line.
Yeah, the team fight from Liquid. It's like Lacoste said, he's these four heroes, he already favors the team just because if they're able to initiate fights, if they can try and ensure that Vici don't get some early pick off to start an engagement, their team fight is insane.
Look at Vici's rotation though. They bring more people in towards the mid lane, which opens up the bottom lane for Beastmaster and opens up the top lane for the Ember Spirit. Like, it's that you're adding the pressure and Liquid to feel confident. Kura's got Rock Up.
Yeah, and they got a Soulbind as well. So,
boy.
We forgot.
Double.
Yeah, Grimstroke Warlock. How could we forget?
Never, ever forget the double soul bind.
They're just pushing. You can't fight into these two supports, and Vici they can't punish because all it is DY, or maybe they can.
Yep. Double Fatal Bonds to get the terminology actually correct. Oh, they already started off. DY gets the Storm down.
Reloading.
You had the Relocator. Looks like Fate thought he was going to go the opposite direction. Kuro gets the soul bind. No, off, actually, the Fatal Bonds.
Oh my god, double Fatal,
they
double Fatal!
Do it! The roar!
Holy shit! Four dead.
About to be five. Ori doesn't get it out of this one. The Weeha birds are following. And they have hit the combo. They've hit the sweet spot. That is the middle of the bat.
All right, so I may have to reevaluate my read on this game, Toby. Because, you're going to need some sort of BKBs. You need a Greaves on the Omni. You need Yul's on the Death Prophet. Because you don't need Gollum. The true ultimate here is the Soulbind into Fatal Bonds. And as you can see, if both of those land, four heroes hit, they immediately died. It was a stroke of fate, one slight, and a roar. And everyone was dead.
Hey, production, I don't know if we got a replay of that in slow motion, but I would love it. VG Gaming, like at least they could defend their tier one tower on bottom lane, but they're bringing four heroes. They need to do something now.
They just weren't fast enough. The Warlock got a Fatal off. If he doesn't, that fight's going VG's way. But I guarantee we look at the damage numbers, Kuro is responsible for more than the rest of his team combined. Like, that's not fair. It's not balanced.
Oh, God. That's Dota. Can I get some OS Frogs in chat? As now Ori being initiated on. Look at the Slide of Fist again. The back lines, they're trapped inside the wall. The rock will drop down. And Ori and Yang, they think they can escape. Maybe with the IO relocate into the back lines to get something to fight with. Ori GA to allow him to fight, but then Miracle, he gets a stun. The Spirit jump forward to get rid of the IO, which means now VG Gaming, they will lose to everybody. All five heroes are dead. A Miracle has an ultra kill. Team Liquid are rampaging over VG in back-to-back fights, the champions of Dota.
You can't fight into this, Toby.
But
it's not a thing. You can't do this. VG Gaming, overconfident. I mean, your Gyro DP, you've got a Wisp, you've got an Omni, you're thinking, you know, you should be the Lords of the mid-game. I think you're Lords of the mid-game, but this is different. It's no longer 2018. You're playing against a brand new hero in the Grimstroke, and just too much damage. You see the Ember Spear, the Flame Guard plus the Ink Swell. The Relocate means nothing. Miracle just handles them both by himself.
Yep. And Yang's trying to go for the denial on the bottom tower. He's staying close. Miracle already got the last hit. They trigger off the drum charge and walk away from Hori. Walk away from the fight. And Miracle walks towards the double damage rune. Glimpse, but a spirit. He'll move forward. There's your silence. They need a follow-up, getting out of the wall, and then jumps over, and the DD rune's all there for him. And he'll counter-initiate. They'd love to go in. Miracle's back up to full. A slide of fist steering chain will do it. They don't see him on the tree lines. The Hawk is watching the left, not the right.
They just have so much damage. The HOD, the Ursa Creep, drums, Vlads. It's 13, 14 minutes in.
Mm-hmm.
You've got so many teamfight items already. Even a medallion as well on Wii. Like, yep. This is the cheapest, most efficient items you can get to ensure your team has the maximum amount of damage output. And even the Purge Creep to get rid of the possible GA that would come out from the Omni Knight.
Miracle, side of Fissurian Chains, able to hit on both Fade as well as Paparazzi. As he moves in deeper, more Sleight of Fist just rips him apart. Oh, Miracle, have you bitten off more than you can chew? The silence, does he have a way out of this one? Sleight of Fist up and Spirit as he's in the fist. My God, this guy's unfistable. They can actually jump back and get another Sleight of Fist, but he can't dodge that one. Paparazzi will finally end the 8-time killing spree of Miracle.
Now, look, I don't want us to, we can't call GG just yet, because remember, Vici Gaming, once they have the ability to deal with the Fatal Bonds, this is a different kind of game. They were bamboozled a little bit in those two mid-game team fights, but thankfully, another change is that hero kills are in general just not worth nearly as much as they were previously. Thus, the gold advantage is still just 2K for Liquid, even though they're up 15-6.
Thank you, Kyle, for getting us back on track. We do not want to run away with our emotions. Calculated analytics.
This is the big item, the BKB on the gyrocopter. That's when Vici Gaming can actually take these engagements. For now, they got to be real cautious. And you can see Liquid, they're going to just keep pushing the tempo. Yes, sure, Miracle dies, but it was on the tier 2 shrine, or the top shrine. And they're getting a tower top for free because there's just so much pressure being output on the map by all these
heroes. Here we go. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Remember, this is Vici. They're trying to take this fight. If the Warlock dies, a totally different story. DY, good initiation, but just watch this. It's right at the last second. Soulbind, Fatal Bonds at the last moment. Oh. And
the raw pushback, the sleight of fist from Miracle is everything.
That was a 5-man Fatal, actually. Five people Fatal Bonded.
That was cool.
And back in the action at the tier 2 now. Do you really want to deal with this, Vici? You've got the Yules now, so at least the Death Prophet can get rid of the Fatal Bonds, keep himself alive.
It's a good Beastmaster Hawk as well, just watching any position coming from the above.
Look at the push damage. This is just creeps.
They're going to lose bottom lane, however. That's the upside about VG's lineup. Is actually, they're not even pushing the lane that hard. They can relocate in. That's what VG's capable of doing. They have a Dire Observer Ward on the hill, so they have really good information on Team Liquid. But Liquid, they're pushing in. The Spirit forward. A first line, a fifth, a silence, and then, Yang will just break free.
You can see how they're terrifying. This is the strength of this draft, the Beastmaster Ember Visage Core combination. So much pressure, but you also can try and get these engagements started without really risking anything. Slight chains, birds forward. If you want to fight this Vici, what's the move? You have to reload in. Yep. You've got a hard commit. And if you do that, and the Liquid supports are able to just wait, get their big spells off, like, everyone's dead.
Yep.
You need to stall until you get these core items, and Liquid recognize this, and they're going to just walk straight into the pit. Love this decision.
But the Observer Wards from Vici Gaming, they see the Northwest, the Northeast from Roshan, so they know Liquid are going, but can they find it?
No, you cannot. That is, this is suicide.
Hey, I've seen Fade pull off some brilliant things, but obviously that was a very, very different hero. And they'll come underneath the Observer and center this plan from Liquid, so at least they can remove that aggressive vision that was down. Actually, do they? They dropped the sentry, but they haven't felt confident enough to move in and actually take out the ward yet. Maybe they don't realize that Liquid's in Roshan. Now they'll come up and take care of it. They'll know now.
They've got an idea. It's Visage Beastmaster. They know that they're not in a position where they could really be defending this. Weeha actually going to finish the Solar Crash. Remember, that still stacks with Medallion. You're going to have one on the Beast, and now the Solar finished on Visage. It's so much plus armor. And
God, where's this BKB from Paparazzi? He's been working on this for so long.
He's almost got it. This is huge, too. Miracle is going to be so fat. Maxed out Flame Guard. He'll have Solar. He'll have plus 20 armor. And in addition, he's got all these auras behind him in addition to the Inkswell. Mm-hmm. So he's just a force to be reckoned with. You can see most kills by 15 minutes in this tournament thus far, and it feels like he hasn't even necessarily had to work too hard for it.
No. At 10-2-4, I think it was. And well, VG will try and do something about it. The BKB's not there just yet, but IO has the mech. So they're getting some more regeneration available. Miracle will just tank. He wants to ensure these outer towers are gone. So 19 minutes and all outer towers of EG Gaming are gone. They're rubble. Here comes your push in. Liquid just using their birds to try and, even with the Inkswell, keep them on the front lines for the stuns. It's a no hero risk.
Yep.
Stuns.
They're just going to keep spamming. Remember, the Disruptor is the only true catch for VG Gaming. And that's really only effective if Liquid are running away from you, which they have no intentions of doing so. How are you going to kill Kuro? That's the question. Mm-hmm. He's just chilling in the tree line, saying, you know, you guys have some fun as they just continuously spam, buff the creeps, Miracle, spam Slight Chains. This tower's at half health already. They got no glyph.
And they have to initiate.
Like
at this point, but
what do you do?
You can't go on the Visage. It takes Silurush to bring him down, and then he's still got the Aegis Immortal. They'll drop their own sentry to get rid of the other sentry. Go beating into the range ranks. And VG Gaming, this will go without a fight. They do not want we. They will not take we. They need something else.
They have the BKB. That's what they needed.
All right.
Perhaps you can think about fighting
DY,
now.
Time for an ultimate. Time for a catch. But again, the only target is Weeha. The birds will drop down. The double stun's out from him. X isn't being burned from Ahri. They move forward. The call down. Trying to make sure there's no other support. Weeha, the Aegis Immortal will burn. But Exism and Call Down both being burnt up. They have to go Disruption Storm as well as follow up wall. Hasn't happened. Weeha just wants to get back out again. They're going to glimpse him back in, but the Soulbind locking him together. The Soulbind's together once again with the Rock Drop. But this time around, it's not a big hit until they hit the back lines. The Spirit Jump forward. Miracle, he's looking for the two supports and he's about to claim him. The IO is one hit away from death. Fate so low, but Miracle can't reach him. VG Gaming, they're barely escaping back out, but remember what Team Liquid came for. They came for the melee racks. That's what they will claim, and then they will retreat.
And VG blew all of their spells. It didn't matter. Liquid ignored them and threw their own barrage back. Eventually, VG's got to retreat back into the base. They popped everything. GP ult, Gyro ult, Omni ult, all used. And Liquid don't care.
Yep.
Because you're not onto the supports. They get all four bounties, they get the mid racks.
And an arcane rune for Miracle,
you can't ask for it. Once he has a BKB, there's no threat whatsoever from VG. They have zero stunts.
Mm-hmm.
You will not be able to control Miracle. We already discussed how much just raw buff up he can receive.
Here they go. Up towards mind control. You'll sit to Framari. They're first. Disable to allow the initiation, but GH just slows him down. A glimpse will come back, but then again, maybe not the perfect positioning for the wall, so Mind Control gets a little bit further up, gets one boar out at least, but the relocate movement, it means GH can TP back to base, but I'm seeing an Ember Spirit wrapping around the back lines. Miracle, he's waiting for a support. Flame Guard up, the Soulbind, it's locking VG together. All he wants to do is kill off that Disruptor, and he's gonna get it as well. The silence doesn't last long enough. Already, Spear is forward, side of Fissurian Chains is available. Yang, gonna try and break free. The Heavenly Grace helping him with that, but Defusal, or actually just a Purge Creep, slows him down, allows for the double stuns, and they get a buyback from Disruptor, but maybe there's another fight, and another silence from Ahri. Paparazzi moving forward, DY, he's TP'd at the shrine, wrapped around the corner. The glimpse, it's over on Weeha. He'll try and tank through this, but inside that wall, there is no tanking. Kuro can't really help. There's no rock to give him over as a Sleight of Fist and then Spirit Jump away. High move for speed. Ember Spirit's on the run. GH even gave the Stroke of Fate to slow down VG and allow both of these heroes to escape.
Really would have loved a glimpse there onto the Ember Spirit, but will not find it. Big streak on Miracle. That'd be a lot of juicy gold.
Yeah, they've already claimed it once.
It's the BKB timing that's going to be critical for Liquid. Around that second Roshan, they're going to look to have that up. You can see, though, VG Gaming's draft still formidable. If you're not in a ball, if Liquid are not five heroes, VG always have that threat to find the Yules, the Glimpse, reel in. Suddenly, they're five heroes on top of two or three. And Liquid, they're not in a position. Their draft isn't capable of skirmishing and buying too much time. They need the Grimstroke Warlock to be there preemptively so that they're ready to turn things around when VG pop their big ults. It's always an IO Gyro.
It's always an IO Gyro. It's always Kuro trying to get the big hits, but it's spelling.
Yep.
VG is starting to get away from that big combination. As you said, fool me once, so shame on you. Yang, well, they saw him for a half moment. The Observe Ward, however, sees DY. More of the pain in the butt. Yang still on the run out of here. Miracle doesn't see him yet.
It's all about just forcing VG back into base so they establish vision now, and they can look to potentially get aggressive, but this is fine. Deny Ancients, kill Bot Shrine. It's all about the next Roshan. Although Liquid, knowing them, they're never ones to back away from a fight. They could bait these two wards they've placed deep in the enemy jungle. Will back away, however. Vici going to need to recover that area of the map soon.
It does display where Liquid want to focus next. You put observer sentries down like this. It's kind of surprising because like Roshan is obviously going to be a very big target for you. But are you trying to move up and control the top jungle? No, you're like, I mean, we just take Roshan. We come in through bottom. Mid will push itself.
Yeah, they're just going to bottle up a rune.
It feels very odd to say that considering we've been sitting here saying bottom lane is always the lane that pushes in. Like for the Dire side, they've always got the momentum on that, and Liquid's just taking it away.
And look at Vici just camping their own base. They know that they cannot win a fight if they walk into Liquid. They've got to try and force disadvantageous fights for Liquid, whether that's based around positioning or just a numbers disadvantage. Love what Crow's doing, just controlling these high grounds in the enemy jungle. He's probably going to get the one on the shrine as well.
Does he find the obs? Like he's pretending his own observer ward, but he did it underneath the vision of VG's obs.
No. You can see it's just real smart from Liquid. They're going to continue sweeping the map. And once again, four bounty runes are going to go their way. Mm-hmm. This is map control 101. BKB finished on Miracle as well. This could be go time. There's no way to control this Ember Spirit any longer. And they really just don't have that physical damage threat to make Miracle man down.
Didn't even know that was a thing. Can you be less of a man? Miracle, be less of a man.
Doubtful.
No, he'll go for everything he's got. Still watching that Roshan timer, so 1 minute until he may respawn. That's still a big open window, Paparazzi.
I think he's got to spend his gold. Yeah. I really do. I don't think a buyback's going to matter here on the gyrocopter. And I don't know if Liquid need to wait for Roshan either.
They're going
to
be tested. So, VG Gaming. Best situation for them is they're able to repel this fight and then go for Roshan, but that's a very best case scenario. And they'll still need Exorcism to actually take Rosh.
Yeah, and just Kuro still spamming sentries all around the map. They did lose one ward in the bottom jungle, but they still have another near where the shrine used to be top. That died to Wii a little while ago. Mm-hmm. And Liquid, you know, they get the one Rax, take it early, and you're always questioning. Like, Vici isn't sure if Liquid's going to try and fight and win the game here. Neither are we. But Liquid, they're just keeping them in their base. Lock them in the crease. They've got 8 consecutive bounty runes. They've killed both shrines. And they now have total map control before Roshan.
VG have Crimson Guard over on the Omni Knight. And they've got a second BKB. This one's over on Ori. So they will feel a lot more confident to move forward. Under the Observe Ward, Weeha thought he was safe to farm up. Supports nearby from Liquid. It's going to be Kuro who can potentially drop the rock. But they glimpse him back, hold him inside the wall. And this is not a fight that Liquid are looking for. They push to the side lanes and get the hell out of there.
It's just we, and Death Prophet ultimate's used. Look at Roshan spawning. 44 seconds, you will have we up just in time to go contest the Roshan, and there's no Death Prophet ultimate. Halberd as well on Mind Control, love that decision. It's all about damage reduction. As long as Vici don't find a way to kill your entire draft in 5 to 10 seconds, you're going to be A-okay. And just raw stats, the Liquid cores and supports being very unselfish. Just Mind Control is always like just... Yeah, putting the team on his back, got the medallion, the Vlad, the Halberd. He's so tanky now. And his whole job is you're going to be a Soulbind, double Roar. And there's not a damn thing you can do to prevent it as Vici Gaming. You can purge off one of them, of course, but not both.
Yeah, if you could just be BKB'd up and just try and tank through it, that's when I think Fade has to lift up and so does Yang. And that's at least a nice combination with them together. Like, if you can get the efficiency heal, having Fade and Paparazzi in the front lines, get a Purification out, keep him up. Death Prophet can take care of herself. And Gyra is taken care of by everybody else.
Yeah.
And Disruptor's like, oh, as long as I get one person caught inside my ulti, maybe that's going to be good enough. Stops the full combination of Liquid coming in. Yep. But they go in for Roshan, and Liquid will be as fast about this as possible.
It's just cool because I love that Liquid, that we're always on the edge of our seats, right? They maybe could have pushed for it. They maybe wanted to fight Vici, but
Vici's coming.
Just by space, it's a free Rosh. There's no way they make this in time.
They're coming closer, though. But Liquid have already done it.
Yeah, they backed the hell away from their AFA. It's not a fight, Toby.
Miracle actually wants one now. It's like, who's going to be hanging around? DY, they see him in the trees because the Hawk is right over the top of him. The Searing Chains, the damage output from Miracle is way too high.
Are you serious? Spirit.
Yeah, I'm serious, man. This guy is good.
He didn't even get glimpsed back. He actually juked the glimpse with a near, like,
a point-blank spirit. He just got the timing right. Now, Tier 3 tower being attacked up. The creep wave hasn't pushed in through mid yet, so this is problematic for Team Liquid. But VG Gaming, they don't have Disruptor for half a minute. No major ability has been burned from Team Liquid. The only thing which is on cooldown is the resummon of the birds.
But this is perfect, because we've seen what how Wii dies, right? He just gets yulzed up, glimpsed back. With a BKB, he's just as invulnerable as Miracle. The physical damage from the Gyrocopter is not there yet, even with this Butterfly.
Oh, Paparazzi, he just needed information on Fade. Soulbind's already up. Paparazzi, they'll purge him free. Now Soulbind over on Yang. The double roar, it does come in. Miracle, he just wants to try and find a kill. The rock will drop as well. Is there some follow-up damage? There's no, the heal. Io keeping Ahri alive. They couldn't get the big hero they wanted, but Miracle's still in the back lines. They'll silence him up, but remember, he's got that cheese available. The glimpse, it'll come in, and Miracle's like, well, okay, I'll fight, and I'll walk out of the wall, and then spirit myself down the bottom of the lane to open up Team Liquid. Weehard, who is the tower pusher to do his work. This is the issue of no stuns, where Miracle can just play like this. It looks good, and he is good, but VG don't really have that many answers they can really rely on. Now the glimpse with a follow-up stun, they're able to get the grab over on Weehar. Kuro can't do much more here. He tries to slow him down with the soul bind. Everyone's put together.
Sorry, the
metal bonds, and maybe with a slight of fist in the back lines, they hurt hard, trying to walk away from the upheaval. The cooldown will arrive. A quick silence, that'll stop it, but Miracle's had all the time in the world to get multiple slight of fist out. Again, Disruptor is gone. The GA will arrive, but there's way too much damage. The Omni will still fall. Buyback available from him. As Io relocates back into the fight, trying to go for a save.
And you can see Miracle just continuously toying around with the enemies. His target is DY, the one disable. If he can kill him off, which he has done so successfully in three fights in a row, Fichi have nothing left to chase. You can see he gets glimpsed back, almost dies, but BKB, drop a Q, run away. Mm-hmm. He's being healed up by Warlock, all the auras. Another round of bounty runes going the way of Liquid, who really just all in for that fight. They didn't exactly hit their combos, they just used their spells.
You know, it's really hilarious too, because Wii's playing like he's expendable.
Yeah.
Every single time it's like, you know what, I'm not a centaur, but still have a crack at me. You've got to get through my cloak, my birds will do the rest of the work.
Oh jeez, a double sheep now available for GH. 10 sure. minutes faster than average, this is spooky. And it's just so easy for them to poke and prod, find that initial kill. DY with no buyback. Miracle will gladly trade his BKB to kill off the Disruptor. They know Death Prophet Ultimate is down as well. Sure, the cheese was used, but Aegis is still active on Wii.
There are too many things that VG needed to dispel.
Yeah.
You could see it the second time around with the Fatal Bonds from Kuro. It was just so difficult to get rid of it all. And that's when you get hit by the slows, you get hit by the double slows, which it's also there. Miracle, that silence from Ahri, he's been working so hard on that Prophet. You have to give him props for working just to try and keep Miracle at least silent, some level of control. The wall is up, they want Weehar's birds. Fatal Bonds again, connecting him up. There's your double side and the double roar. Everyone gets pushed back. They'll come into the storm. The relocate save, huge from Io. Fade doing the work when it counts. Miracle's BKB will wear off. Mind control, he'll be the one. Glimpse back into the wall. They just want to let him die. 52 seconds without him. And VG Gaming, the cleanest we saw in game one, needed right there, and they had it.
Yep, they're playing as well as you can hope for. They put themselves in a tough spot after those two abysmal fights they took very early into the game. But you can see the difficulty Liquid has. Sure, you don't have catch on Vici, but it's tough to get kills if Fade's Wisp isn't dealt with. It's the second time he sent a nice reload to save out his core, and you see Papa just immediately TP back into the fight once he's full HP. Really well done there by Vici. And they also go for the Beastmaster, who...
He's a lot easier to kill.
Yeah.
Especially, they didn't want to go on Wii. Like, he had Aegis the Immortal. If you went on Wii, it's a waste of abilities, and Liquid would have just continued to push.
Yep. It's just about finding that right initiation. I think in the next engagement, Liquid, they're going to continue learning from this. They need Miracle or GH to find the supports in the back line as the Roar Soulbind Fatal goes out on one of the cores, but it's DP Gyro, it's a Wisp. Like, there's so much sustain, especially we're not even counting the Omni Knight of Yang. It's difficult as this game continues for Liquid to find ways to get kills in their burst windows, because that's how they won those fights earlier. There were 3 to 4 second engagements. Now that they're being more dragged out, the strength of the Gyrocopter we start to see come full force, and this is before the level 20 talent on Wisp. That's where things shift in Vici's favor significantly.
So how does Liquid break the base? How the hell do they get in? Can they continuously force the way they're currently doing it?
They can. They're still expanding upon their gold lead. The concern is just that you know, a lot of the net worth advantage, because it's mostly through these bounty runes, it's spread across the Liquid heroes. It's not like one guy is getting this next item advantage, whereas on Vici, even though they're so far behind, Paparazzi is the top net worth in this game, and he's continuing to scale. That's Satanic and the Ag's timing. That's mm-hmm. where things start to shift. Level 17 on the Wisp. They need that one fight. Satanic so good in this game, just for the status resist, and mm-hmm. we've seen the difficulty Liquid have in long fights. This yeah. just allows the gyrocopter to ensure he can stick in it and also keep himself in front of his squad, prevent Miracle from being able to freely dive onto the Disruptor Wisp in the back line.
Yeah, actually punish him. Like, if Miracle's going to go, he goes alone. And then Paparazzi is like, well, okay, I'll take the rest of your team. But Liquid are still looking for that opening. Yeah. VG, they're starting to feel a little bit more confident to come yeah. outside their base. And hilarious enough, when VG feel more confident, that's actually opportunities yeah. that start to arrive for Team Liquid. See, what does VG do? All right, guys.
Back into the base.
Everybody, let's just form a nice big trust circle.
Yep.
Big trust circle. Everyone, we are all in this together.
Yep.
Get the head in the game.
I really like what... Ori's done here, just with the Lotus Orb. You just need more methods of getting rid of these damn Fatal
Bonds. They smoke off, but it's right in front of Team Liquid. Wii's already there. The smoke's going to break instantly.
Double Sheep.
The Soulbind and the Double Sheep. This is not what they wanted. The Double Roar as well. The damage is too much for VG Gaming. They transport out of it. Miracle still in the back lines with a Double Soul Assumption too. Sure, go for it. Io has to buy back into this game. He needs to give the life to the front lines. They've already got the kill over on the Grimstroke. As Ori isolated. Wee-ha. He's just being surrounded at the moment around on Ori. Does he have enough damage? There's your Double Soul Assumption again. He have enough damage to bring down Ori. He has no buyback available. Miracle, he's ready to jump in once more. A perfect Searing Chains. This may just be the game. VG Gaming, they won't really have buybacks available here. Omni does, but they don't have it on their big ones. And if the big one does go down, he doesn't have the Satanic yet. He doesn't have that resistance. They've got the Gyro pushing for the Tier 4 towers, pushing for a Game 3 to decide who will be the first team into the Epicenter Grand Final. Liquid has the call out from him. We're going to decide to wrap up the night of our first day here in the arena.